bacon. You like bacon?
We're back.
We are back.
That boy needs therapy.
Psychosomatic.
That boy needs therapy.
Purely psychosomatic.
That boy needs therapy.
You're lying down on the couch.
What does that mean?
You're a nut. You're crazy in the coconut.
What does that mean?
That boy needs therapy.
Hi everyone. Wild camper here. So we've arrived. And the camo kid. So we've arrived at the Preppers 100. It's more like, I think, 150 now. And we've set up. Been lucky with the weather so far. Just walking back from the forest, we decided we'd go in the field because...
Much quieter.
Not necessarily much quieter, just a bit easier. Yeah. And a bit of laziness, really. Had the car, so I'm parked right next to it. So I'll show you a little bit once we're there. So we've just met up with the guys, seen all the YouTube favourites, and they are just as fantastic in person as they are on their videos, if not better. So it's a pleasure to meet them all. And Jack's made a few friends, haven't you?
Yeah.
Some of the other people's kids have come along, so he's happy. And yeah, the farm's great. It's very nice. Had a little wander around. We're just going back for a bit of lunch now because we were getting a bit hungry. We had an early start this morning. We haven't had much to eat yet. So just wandering back up from the... What do we have?
Quick lunch.
We'll have a quick lunch.
No, not a quick lunch, a quick breakfast.
So we've just come up from the lane there. And the gang are in this forest here. But I thought I'd show you. Cute. We found the pub, nice. And Jack was made a friend with Brooke, is it?
Yeah.
And I think her dad Glenn, we've been having a chat and pitched up next to each other. So we thought we'd just try out all the facilities and start with the pub.
Invisibles and
Invisibles. So the weather has turned out to be quite nice because I think it was supposed to be
windy.
Lashing rain, wasn't it, Jack? Do you remember on the thing?
On the course.
So yeah, we've been very lucky there. So just having a pint and a chat, putting the world to rights as you do, and then we better be sociable and go back to the rest of the group. It's been an interesting mix. It's nice to see everyone out and enjoying themselves over the weekend. Is it hot,
so
Curry?
Hot.
It really isn't, but it is a little bit. So. We're at base camp.
Back again.
We've taken the field because of various reasons, which I won't bore you with, but the forest wasn't possible.
No way.
Own choice and all that. So we've got a communal fire, which is looking good for later on. Today we're going with the Dutch Ridge tent and a bit of a tarp on the back of the Gulf. It'll do. Probably about 30 to 50 people in the forest, which is somewhere over here, I think memory serves. So we've got our neighbours that we met today, Brooke and Glenn. They've been helping us out with a few things. Jack, my son, in the green, has been playing with Brooke, the little girl there. That's going to be our fire for later, so I'm looking forward to that. Great atmosphere here, actually, I have to say. Everyone's been really helpful. So we're in the Dutch army tent, which I'm still jury still out on this, I've got to be honest with you. I'm not sure if it's for me. All over. It's an interesting tent. It is what it is. We've got my sleeping bag here. Jack's there, and we've got like the Austrian Army
insert for the sleeping bag. This is his first outing. We're going to use it. We're going to undo it and use it like a blanket for two of us. Like a Muppet, I forgot my tent poles. So a little bit of a hole there, look. So not my tent poles, my tent pegs. Sorry, I've been in the pub all afternoon and had to borrow a few from people. But anyway, we'll manage.
You done?
Bacon. You like bacon? Hi guys, wild camper again. So we've had our dinner and very nice it was too. So what we're doing is now we're going back down that lane you saw us go up earlier on, and we're going to just have a little mooch around the woods for half an hour and then go back to our part of the field where the other preppers are, and YouTubers and whatever else.
We're just going where our friends are. Not all of them.
They're all friends. One of them. They're all friends, but we've made friends, haven't you?
Yeah.
We're wandering back over to the woods now just to check in on Funky Prepper and the gang. We met them all earlier on. It's a fantastic people, but it's just you don't want to sort of stand over them for hours at a time and sort of get in their way, if you like.
I'm really sort of this way.
We just spent half an hour with them earlier on, about 5 minutes with each, and then went back to our section.
She's gonna win a prize.
There are two confessions that I have to make. One is that there are 101 people in a raffle. Right? I sat watching my computer till 1 o'clock in the morning and I had sold 97 tickets. And I sat there till 1 o'clock in the morning thinking, I'll just wait till the last three tickets get sold. And I went to bed. When I woke up in the morning, there were 101 tickets that were sold. And a couple of those people didn't give me an email address, so I couldn't get back to them to say, I'm sorry, but you know, you're out of the raffle. So I've left that extra ticket in. And the other confession I have to make is that your prize is in the boot of my wife's car. But she will be back for breakfast in the morning. So I can't give it to you right
now.
It's
on a road trip.
But I can give you the beautiful Jacklaw. That this was the first Jacklaw I ever got a few quid together and bought off of Sandy. I sent it back to him. He has reconditioned it for me. It's the one with my name on it. And it is it's beautiful. So I can give you this kind of right now. Brooke is going to pick us a number in here. Oh, 100 bits of paper. What I want you to do is pick out one number. And tell us what it is.
79.
Number 79.
Whoa. That's for the kids.
Okay, so if anyone has number 79, that's brilliant. If you use Jamie Wallace, and you are the winner of the prize in total. So if you're not here today, I'll that's it. Thank you.
Big enough, aren't they?
Big enough than my mobile mouth.
No, not there. Nowhere near that.
Plenty of wood.
There was nowhere near that. No, I thought it would be.
Oh, he's going to go on fire. Do you want yours on fire? In a minute, would you like another one? Oh, you can actually put it right in the fire.
You don't want to get one of them sticks stuck right down in there.
Do you need help blowing?
Burn me!
Morning, everyone.
So we survived the night. Just going for a little walk around the perimeter this morning before the rain starts. We've been very fortunate, and I think we had a little bit of rain in the early hours. Late night, some of the guys stayed up to about, I think it was about 2:30, and as any of you that have been to these sort of things, or any other campsite for that matter, it can be a little challenging to sleep when there's a good party going on outside. But obviously, I had to look after the camo kid here, so that's fair enough. And I was a little bit tired anyway. So we're just going on a final stroll around before we leave. You probably can hear the wildlife in the background. It's lovely. We're all packed away, aren't we, Jack? Everything's done.
Yeah.
And yeah, we're getting there. Oh, I can hear the church bells as well. So what do you think, Jack? Was it good?
Yeah.
Come back again?
Yeah.
Where would you rather be next time? In the forest or in the field?
Maybe still in the field, because that was quite good.
Yeah, it was good for the kids to run around, I must admit.
Because those toilets.
Yeah, they're pretty basic,
and but it was,
did the job, a shed with a hole.
It was compost toilet.
Yes, they were okay. Served a purpose. So we're going to walk around now and walk through the forest, say our goodbyes. I haven't really done much filming in there because, well, I feel a bit like I'm invading on people's privacy. So, I don't know. Maybe we'll come back and have a little bit with Jack and myself with the gang. That's where the funky man is, just there. Just looking at the wood from the other side. Up sort of this end, you just walk round it and it's a lot nicer than the bottom end, in the sense of there's no massive stinging nettles for the kids to get stung on, and just more space really. Beautiful. The forest guys have parked all their cars. We walked up to there earlier on. We're just walking around. A morning stroll, working up a bit of an appetite.